Hello. It is me, not in person, obviously. So sorry that I haven't been there for the past couple blocks. I'm okay. I just have to go to a doctor's appointment tomorrow morning and totally forgot about it, but I'm here now. I felt bad about not being able to explain to you guys the autobiography project, so I'm here to do that now. First off, if you didn't see the slide in the daily slides from yesterday about titling your project, then please, please, please go ahead and in Schoology or in your Google Drive, go ahead and open up that project. You're not turning it in today. I don't count on you finishing it today. Totally fine. But when you open your project, just make sure that your project description looks something like the example that I had up on last class's slide. So it should be slides for days September or 9, 5, and 6, I think. But there should be an example that when you title your projects for any digital thing that you turn in to us, should have your last name and first initial, and then I like to put a hyphen to kind of separate where my name is and the title of my project. You don't necessarily have to, and then as long as your project title is relevant, I'll take it. In the example, I just wrote Autobio, or Autobio Project would be totally fine too, but this is just an example. Using my name, your title should look something like this. So last name, first initial, and then the title of the piece of writing or the digital thing that you're turning into me. Cool? Cool. So on to the project description. So some of you may have heard of an autobiography or a biography before. If you have or have not, this is a little refresher. So an autobiography is auto, the word part means self. Like an automobile means like a car you can drive yourself. Does that make sense? So auto means self, and a biography is the telling of a person's life. So an autobiography would be the story about your life up until now. So all we're doing for this writing assignment is talking about you. There may be some physical copies of this brainstorm available for you. There may not. Does depend on what was left over on my desk and if I put it in the right location. But if there isn't a physical copy, you'll be okay, I promise. So this first part of the autobiography, which you may or may not have started last block, is about your family. So topic sentence I will touch on in a little bit. Ignore that for now. I want you to complete your brainstorm before you go on to anything else, okay? So your brainstorm, this is notes for you. You can write this, you can detail this however you want to detail it. If you think best in complete sentences, go ahead and brainstorm in complete sentences. If you think best in not English, then write your bullet points or write your sentences in not English. If you are super visual like Mrs. Reyes's and you prefer to think in pictures and colors, then go ahead and use the space for that. This is also not the only space that you're confined it to when you do your brainstorm. You can use a different piece of paper. This brainstorm is for you to help you organize your thoughts, okay? So within this brainstorm, I want you to answer each of these three bullet points. In parentheses are just sentences, are just suggestions. They're not like you have to answer all of these questions. They're just suggestions. But what I do want you to write about are your family members. So say, do you have any siblings? Do you want to talk about how you live with your parents or uncle or older brother, something like that? If I were to write this, I would mention that I have one sibling and I live with two parents right now. My one sibling is in the military, so I could mention that. Just whatever family members that you would like to talk about them here. Write out your brainstorm on, oh, well, maybe I really like my sister because she enjoys the same shows I watch, or it really annoys me when my brother comes home from school and all he wants to do is watch Peppa Pig. Things like that. Just talk about your family members. The next thing that I want you to mention is a little bit about your family history. Where do you come from? If it were me writing this project, I'd probably talk about how both my parents immigrated from the Philippines. That's part of my family history. I might talk about what heritage is running through me. I've got Filipino, I've got Spanish, and those are my main two. So family history is just where does your family come from, or different parts of your family come from. Maybe you yourself and your immediate family are all from the US, but maybe your aunt or something, oh well, she was born in Poland. That's pretty interesting. It's part of your family history, something important to share. And the last thing that I want you to talk about are your family traditions and customs. If there's something special that you do every single year, some of your families might be really into Christmas or Halloween or Easter, or you might do something special if you celebrate Eid, or if you spell or if you celebrate the Day of the Three Kings in February, if you are of Latin descent. So, and it doesn't necessarily have to be holidays if your family's super isn't crazy about all of that, but they go all out for your birthday, or you celebrate your dog's birthday every single year because they're an integral part of the family. That would be a tradition or a custom if you celebrate that every single year. So go ahead and talk about that. And those are the three bullet points that I would like you to hit in this first paragraph. So all of those in your brainstorm, you may write as much as you feel. For the most part, when you brainstorm, you're going to write more information than you actually need. And usually when you brainstorm, you'll write it in shorthand. So not complete sentences, maybe just phrases. So in my brainstorm, I think in bullet points, I think in a lot of bullet points, when I give stuff to you guys, you might see it's in bullet point form. So I think in bullet points, so if my first would be, oh, well, I have one sibling. Cool. Their name is Morgan, and I have two parents. I live with them. Something like that. Both immigrant parents. My family likes Christmas. Maybe you would just write Christmas, and you would understand what that means. Brainstorms, you don't have to make it make sense for us. It just has to make sense for you, because this is your notes, these are things that you are using. So go ahead and take the next few minutes to finish up your brainstorm here. If you have finished up your brainstorm here, take the next few minutes and go on to part two. This part is just about you. You don't have to write about all of these bullet points. These are all just suggestions for you to use. But you could pick one or two and go into detail about them, or if you wanted to do all of them, then of course you may. And just go ahead and either, if you're working in part one or part two, go ahead and take about 5-ish minutes and complete that brainstorm. Go ahead and pause the video right now, throw up a 5-minute timer or something, go, and I'll see you back in a couple minutes. Which is actually a few seconds because I'm recording this all the way. No cuts for me. So, once you are done with your brainstorm, once you're done with your brainstorm, it is almost time for you to go ahead and start writing. topic sentences. So, what you may be familiar with is a thesis statement, not a topic sentence. So, thesis statements, which is something that you may be familiar with, may look a little bit like talking about in detail what you are about to talk about in your essay. So, for example, say you were writing about a few causes of World War I, let's say. Because World War I is actually really, really interesting politically, but I won't get into that. So, say, for example, that you were talking about World War I, a thesis statement might be something like World War I was caused by alliances, militarism, and oh, what was the other one? Oh, nationalism. That's an example of a thesis statement, because usually you would have a paragraph describing why alliances caused World War I, and then why militarism caused World War I, and then why nationalism caused World War I. Okay? A thesis statement isn't necessarily what we're looking for if we're just writing a paragraph. Topic sentences are a lot more general. They simply introduce the thing that you are going to talk about in a very broad way. So, for example, the overall theme of this paragraph is obviously going to be about your family, right? That's what the entire paragraph is about. So, perhaps for your topic sentence, since this would be technically like the first part of your essay, maybe you'd introduce yourself by name. And then you might introduce your paragraph about family with talking about perhaps, oh, I don't know, like why family is important to you. Thank you, Windows Security. Go away. Business. Oh, I just realized you can't see all of that. Boop. And there. Okay. So your topic sentence, or technically sentences, because I introduced myself since this is going to be like the first part of your essay in parts. This right here would be like your real topic sentence. Okay, I don't have a big family in the US, but they are important to me. So if you notice, this is very broad. This is just introducing the stuff I'm going to talk about. Family is important to me. I don't have a very big one, obviously, because I only have one sibling and I live with two of my parents. But they're very important to me, going into, oh, here's a bit of my family history right here, and then here's a little bit about a tradition that we celebrate. Does that make sense? So go ahead and figure out your topic sentence. If you would like to use the same format of topic sentence that I did, go ahead and do that. I will leave this up here. You can pause the video in order to copy that down in your own way. Maybe you do have a very big family that lives here. Then don't say that you don't have a big family, just say that you do, and say that they are important to you. And then the rest of the paragraph is simply filling in all of the details. Once you have your topic sentence, go ahead and scroll down to page 2. And here in page 2 is where you are going to put all of that together. Don't worry about the conclusion sentence quite yet. I will be back to talk you through conclusion sentences as well, but first off, I want you to get your parts 1 and 2 super solidified, okay? Something I like to do when writing essays and my brainstorm is right next to me, I know, making things so convenient for you, is I like to go Control C and then Control V and then talk around my bullet points. So this is a note that I made. In order to turn that into paragraph form, I would say I have one sibling. Their name is Morgan. Maybe more details. Whoa. Thank you, spell check. And you can fill in as many details as you would like. And you can do that with all of your bullet points. If you think better in a stream of thought, then go ahead and take whatever thinking that you did in your brainstorm and write it on down here. Obviously, you have your topic sentence now, or at least you should, so all you can do is copy that, boop, and then paste that right there. I have it a little funky just so that you guys can see it. Your paragraphs will obviously look more like paragraphs instead of this mess so that you can read what I wrote. Does that make sense? If you have any questions, feel free to email me. I will get back to you at my earliest convenience. More than likely, if I am still waiting at the doctor's office, I will still get back to you. But go ahead and do that brainstorm and write a topic sentence for both parts 1 and 2. If you would like to work ahead and do part 3 as well, looks like that, you may. This is going to take a little bit longer. This may require some more brainstorm time. So I would recommend that you do spend a decent amount of time with paragraphs 1 and 2. But if you finish early, go ahead and look at paragraph 3 or part 3 and start brainstorming for that as well. I will see you guys next class. Just as a reminder, your sub should remind you as well before you leave. Please bring all of your binding materials, if you have them, to our next class on 9/11. You should also be reminded that your MEMDI money is also due. If for whatever reason you can't get your binder materials, I will have materials for you, but I don't have enough for everyone. So those of you that can go out and get the materials, please, please, please do that before Monday, 9/11. Cool? Both Mrs. Reyes and I will see you then, and have a wonderful day. Que tengas un buen día.